Yeah, good afternoon, YouTube. So this is my Hutch fireplace insert. It's what they call their double wall insert. I purchased this, I think, in like 1987, and I had it installed by a local chimney sweep fireplace company. I really haven't touched this thing since it was put in. When they installed the insert, they put a 6-inch diameter stainless steel liner in the chimney, and that's real easy to clean. You just run a brush down and pull it back up and it's cleaned out, ready to go. Several years ago, I made a video showing the insert with a fire in it, and I use this from time to time. I mainly heat the house with solar hot air panels, and then this fireplace insert is my backup heat. So the only problem with using this as my backup heat source is that periodically the local air quality district issues what they call spare the air days, and they don't allow any wood burning fires. That means I can't run the fireplace insert. In the winter, we tend to get these spare the air days. Now, luckily, those spare the air days are usually clear and sunny, and you just get the temperature inversion, which traps the pollutants down at ground level, and that's when they have the spare the air days, but I get enough sun on those days for the solar heat to work. When it gets cloudy and windy, when there's a storm, I don't get the solar, but typically I can run the stove because there's no spare the air day. There's enough air circulation to keep the air clear, and they don't have a spare the air days. Anyway, I've had a few viewers ask how to get to the blower that's in here. So this insert has the blower in this front part. There's a single squirrel cage blower that's right in the middle there. And then on this side, you've got a switch. So anyway, I've got that unplugged. And the way you get in there is there's a panel on each side. And there's three screws you take off with a nut driver there. And you can take the panel off of both sides. In the back there, right about there and about there on the other side, there's a screw like this. It takes a 7/16 socket. Those two screws hold the fan enclosure to the fireplace insert. So I've got those out, and now the whole thing just slides out there. And then we'll see if we can get into the fan, because I felt in from this side and I could feel there's a bunch of leaves and pine needles. When this fan runs, it just sucks stuff up in those grills, and then it gets caught inside the squirrel cage on the blower. Got the blower housing flipped over. There's, like I said, a bunch of leaves and junk got sucked up inside there. That's all the stuff that got sucked up inside of here. Just all these leaves and whatnot. So I'll get that cleaned up afterwards. But there's just two screws. There's one right here and then one on the other side. Just need a nut driver there. Okay, there's the fan out of there. Yeah, you can see how the squirrel cage part is just full of debris in there. Okay, yeah, that's what I suspected. I was looking around for replacement fans for this, and it is a Fasco model 7063-6568. Oh, oil every 6 months. That was one thing I was wondering, was if you could oil the bearings in here. And apparently every 6 months. It's been over 30 years. This thing's always had a little bit of vibration. It's probably because all that junk packed in there, because this sits up. And so anything that gets sucked in here gets sucked into the wheel right here. And you can see how it just packs in with all sorts of debris. Okay, used my air hose and blew the blower out. The video I saw said you need to take the blower off, so I pulled off these three nuts. They're 5/16, and I marked where the wires came out here so I can get this back on. Yeah, there we go. Set screw right there, and then you can pull the fan off. Yeah, just 1/8 inch Allen key. Got the blower wheel out, and then there's the end of the fan motor, and you can see there's a
good bit of junk on there. This end is welded here. So what you need to do is pull these four clips here out, and then you can lift the top of the motor out. There's one bearing here, and then of course there's one bearing down here. Yeah, I think this screwdriver might work a little better. It's got just a narrower blade. You just want to catch the very end of it. There we go. There's three clips. This one is a little tricky because it's got all the wires. You have to kind of get off to the side. If you can see that one, there's like a piece of metal behind there. That's why I couldn't get in. Just barely under the end. There we go. There are the two oil ports. I didn't even see that one on the bottom. Okay, we'll see if this oiler works in there. Yeah, it's going down there. In fact, let's just take a peek here, see if I got oil in there. Oh, okay, that's the oil port right there. That must be the oil reservoir. Actually, what I might do, while I have this end out, yeah, you could put a lot of oil in there then. And just get some more, soak that in there good. And supposedly this whole thing will lift right out. There you go. Yeah, I might actually want to blow that out a little bit, get some of that dirt out of there. Okay, yeah, blew out the inside as much as I could. Shaft looks okay. I don't see any wear on it. We can drop this back down inside right there. And then that one right there. And then you're going to clip that in, get the bottom or the side clipped in. Get the clip in there. So you got that hanging over the top. And then you want to get your clamp on there. Squeeze it in. There we go. Okay, not sure if that shows up, but you can see the little ring where the set screw end was. And so what I did was I removed the set screw from the blower wheel, and I want to just see how far down this has to go. Yeah, right about there. You know, there's the grills on the side here will keep the big stuff out, but this sits up off of the ground. There's kind of a gap here, and I think what happens is leaves and debris get sucked underneath here, and they go up and get into the blower, because this blower is sitting up, so it just sucks everything up off the ground. Maybe put some weather stripping. Maybe that's what I'll do. Put a little bit of weather stripping on here, just so it seals down tight against the hearth, because the problem is the hearth is made out of bricks and it's uneven. Right here, there's the thermo switch. So this is the bimetallic switch that runs the fan if you're in the automatic position. So this piece here touches the firebox, and when it gets hot, it'll turn on the fan, and then it runs, and then once it cools off, it'll shut off. Yeah, one other thing I want to take care of before I put this back together. This is the screw that goes right up in there to hold this to the firebox, and that's their grounding point. So here's the ground wire from the motor, and then this is the incoming one. That one is fine. They used a large enough ring terminal. This is a 1/4-inch screw, and it looks like they probably used a 3/8 ring terminal. But the motor end, you can see they used like a star-shaped one. And the problem is the screw threads into those serrations there. As you try to turn the screw, the wire wants to turn with you, and it gets all twisted up and it starts fighting you. You know, you turn the screw part way and then it turns back. So I think what I'm going to do is I've got a step drill there. I'm going to try to drill that out. Hold this with a pair of pliers and see if I can open up that hole a little bit. Okay, I think that did the trick. Now I can turn the screw inside of the ring terminal and it doesn't catch. So yeah, that'll make putting this back together quite a bit easier, I think. Yeah, so anyway, last night I was looking at this and there was a few spots on here where
I don't know if some water got on here and it started to rust and kind of bubble the paint up a little bit. So I wire brushed off all the rough spots. So I took some sandpaper and sanded off some of the rougher areas and gave this a coat of paint. And let's take off my masking tape here. So I kept the Hutch logo, got that kind of polished up with the wire brush. And so then I put some weather stripping along the bottom and on the sides there. You can probably see that a little bit. Okay, YouTube, there we go. I think that weather stripping is actually going to be just about right. I think that was half inch thick. It fills in the gap here between the bricks. There's a little bit of a gap down here. Yeah, as far as the switch, I think that if you go all the way forward, it's off. And then there's three automatic speeds. So there's like low, medium, and high with the thermostat. And then if you go all the way back, that's the high speed manual. And there we go, it's blowing air. But none of the vibration that I was getting before. All nice and smooth. So I think I need to pick up some high temperature barbecue paint and paint the rest of this thing. Maybe do that this summer when I can open up the room here and my wire brush, wire wheel on the angle grinder and kind of clean this off. Yeah, I think at least the blower is all sorted out. Yeah, it is possible to service these. And yeah, it was really nice putting this back together since I opened up the hole in that one round terminal. That one was so tight, as you turned the bolt, it was turning the ground wire because it was stuck in the threads. And the tighter it got, it kept unwinding the bolt. So now you can just shove the bolt in. And I found like one of these gear wrenches worked really well. This one's got a slight bend to it because you can get that on the head of the bolt and then just work it up and down. Yeah, so I'll put a link to the blower, and I think that link also has some links to the Thermo-Switch and in case you need to replace those. I think these things are pretty generic. A company like Hutch didn't go out and design some brand new parts. They used a standard thermostat, a standard switch, a standard blower. So the part number has been superseded. So like I say, I'll put a link in the video description to the blower part number if you need to replace that. But they seem to be pretty easy to service. Oh, and my solar heat just kicked on. So yeah, we're getting a little bit of heat today before the storm blows in. So I got to go open up the air vents and let the hot air get in the house. But yeah, that's how to fix up one of these Hutch double wall insert. And it's still working today. I still use it a couple times a year. So anyway, yeah, if you have any questions or have any tips or tricks, go ahead and post that up. I'll put a link to my previous video with a fire in here over on the left-hand side. And as always, thanks for watching.